This hanging mass is made entirely of bees. The swarm can hold itself together, even when shaken about by the wind. Now, a team of scientists have been finding out how. About once a year, colonies of honeybees leave their nests in swarms, searching for a new home. Until they find a new site, the bees rest in these temporary clusters. The clusters are often found in trees, but this one is forming in a lab at Harvard in Massachusetts. Little do the bees know, they're about to go for a ride. The researchers built this shaking apparatus to investigate how the bee swarm reacts to movement. When shaken from side to side, shearing forces act on the colony, with the bees at the top taking the brunt of it as they try to hold up everything beneath them. The forces threaten to destabilize the whole colony, so the bees do something clever. They spread out. The flatter shape changes the colony's center of mass, and so it wobbles less, reducing the pressure on the bees. It makes sense. Imagine you're standing up and you find the ground shaking beneath you. Instinctively, you'd crouch down. Same principle. Anyway, what's particularly interesting here is that the forces at play are acting on the swarm as a whole, but each bee can't see the shape of the swarm, so how does it know where to go or what to do? To find out, researchers tracked the bees on the outside of the swarm. As the colony shook, they moved upwards to where the stress is greatest. The researchers modelled this behaviour and found that if all the bees follow the rule, move towards the area of higher stress, the colony flattens out, increasing its stability and so decreasing the average stress on each bee. Great for the colony, but individual bees are actively putting themselves under more stress to do it. This kind of altruistic behaviour is not very common in nature, except that is in eusocial insects like bees and ants, which rely on altruism for survival. What's more, even though each individual bee doesn't necessarily know what's going on, by simply moving towards an area of higher stress, the colony as a whole acts intelligently. This is called emergent intelligence, and some scientists think that it's through a process like this that individual neurons firing in our brain can collectively come together to make, well, us. Talk about a hive mind.